Hi guys, welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video. My name's James. Today we're going to be installing this Kingspan Tribune cylinder in here. It's an absolute beast. I want to show you about the pre-plumbed aspect of it. I want to show you what pipes we've got going in there and why. And hopefully as apprentices, you'll get a better idea about what Unvented systems are all about and what are the advantages of having them. Please subscribe to our videos by clicking on the link that's appearing right now. And remember to follow us on Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, and Twitter, where we have loads more competitions and silliness going on. I hope you enjoy the video, guys, and remember to hold tight. Plumberparts.co.uk, home of Find Your Plumber. Right then, guys, so here we've got our lovely Kingspan cylinder right here, and it's gonna go in the cupboard just out of shot at the moment. What I wanna do is draw your attention to the pre-plumbed aspect first. Personally, I've not really fitted a load of pre-plumbed cylinders. I don't usually do it, and I thought, just on a whim, I was like, I'm gonna do it this time, okay? I just wanna give it a go, see what it's like. I tell you what, guys, it's what I'm doing from now on. Really, really cost-effective for a start. For about an extra 100 odd quid, I've got a velo pump on this, and I've got three Honeywell two-port valves, and we all know how much one of them costs as well on top. And plus, all the wiring and everything's within there as well, so the sparky's happy. If we actually have a look at the inlets and outlets on this tank, firstly up top, we've got our hot water outlet. That's going to be going off to our taps. We've got our secondary return that I've capped off. We've done videos on secondary returns, but just very quickly, a secondary return is effectively a brass pump on a small loop for hot water. So if you've got a tap that's miles away from the tank here, and you don't want to be drawing off loads and loads of cold water before it gets hot, you have a little loop that goes out there. So there's hot water going around there all the time, and it effectively means that the hot water service is closer to that tap. Remember, if you are doing a secondary return system, make sure that number one, the pump is on a timer if you need it to be, and also that the flow and return for that little loop as well is very well insulated. Up here we've got our standard combination valve coming in. Now the first thing I want to draw your attention to on this here is the fact that we don't have a flexible external expansion vessel for the potable water side of the system on this, because the Range Tribune has its own expansion inside the tank itself, which has a number of advantages. Number one, obviously, you don't have the space of taking up an expansion vessel in the cupboard. Number two, also it means that they're able to put extra insulation on this, meaning that the tank is actually a lot more efficient. Thirdly, not only does it save time on installation as well, because you don't have to put an external expansion vessel on, but also it reduces maintenance costs as well. This one has the hot outlet at the side for installation ease. It's a lot easier having it on the side like that. And on the sizes thing, it's worth noting as well that these cylinders come in loads of different sizes. So then, let's have a look at the cylinder itself and also at the cupboard where it's going to be installed. I mean, when I'm speccing out a system, I always look for where the boiler flow is, and on this we've got our boiler flow coming up in 28 mil up here through this velo pump that's integrated with the pre-plumb system. It pops up here and goes round. We've got our two-port valve here for our hot water coil in there to heat up our hot water. We've got a two-port valve down here. The two-port valve for the radiators upstairs. We've also got another two-port valve on here, which is even better because we've got a underfloor heating system on this house as well. Looking around here, we've got an automatic bypass in as well, so we don't have to worry about installing one of them. That's going to go down off back to the boiler. Just on the side here, that could have been the return for one of these two, but I'm actually sending the returns back outside of that cupboard, so we don't need that. But what I am doing is sending that up to the expansion vessel for the heating system. Now, a couple of good things I'd like to point out. When I bought this, I literally did not know what was going to turn up. It was like one of those, like, what's going to happen here? When this turned up, I was over the moon. Didn't expect to be getting an expansion vessel for the heating system side, with a bracket, with the manifold, with the gauge and everything, but also to have the filling loop integrated. It literally saves so much time. So inside the cupboard, what I always do is I'll sit the tank in here first. I'll draw a semicircle around the bottom of the tank or wherever I can, make a mark so I know where the front of the tank is going to be, and then I can ascertain exactly where I want all my outlets to be, and then neatly plumb everything in first with loads of brackets, and also, more importantly, pressure test everything first, okay? So what we've got coming up here, this is our cold water in, this is off the softened water supply, and that is gonna pop round the front and go into the top of our combination valve, probably around about here. Just at the back here, we've got our balanced cold feed out. Now, when I say balanced cold feed, I mean that that has gone through the pressure reducing valve on our combination valve that's gonna be around here. And that means that if you've got things like bar mixer showers, you know, any mixer tap or anything like that, the hot and cold pressures are gonna be balanced and the same. The last thing you want is the cold water main to not be balanced, coming through at like 7 bar, and then you've got a 3.5 bar balanced hot main, trying to work against it. It's just not going to happen, is it? It's going to push down. You're not going to get hardly any hot water out. So that's why we have a balanced cold feed out along with the hot. At the top here, we've got our hot feed out, so that should just be nice and easy. It's just going to drop and come into the front of the tank. But the reason I've pressure tested beforehand is the last thing I want to do is put my tank in here, fill it all up, and realise that I've got a leak at the back with 250 litres worth of water in the way before I can even get to that to fix the leak. So I've pressure tested this now already, and I'm happy that there's no problems. So as you can see, we've got our expansion vessel up here. We've got our manifold with our gauge on it. We've got a high pressure relief valve as well. This pipe here will need to be connected to the heating system without any valves on it. This pipe here, which I've got to say is a bit minging because it's got two 22 mil straights on it, oops. And also that inch and a half there that before it was screeded was upright, and I came back and it's like this. I was like, magic. Obviously we've got a little MAC valve on that. So this is gonna be the pipe that takes our high pressure relief from the tun dish. That means we're gonna have high pressure relief from the combination valve and also from the heating system as well. And then down here, we've got our return to the boiler, we've got our underfloor heating system flow, and we've got our radiators flow. And obviously, like we said a minute ago, this pipe here is our flow up to the expansion vessel. Now, I can't stress this enough. The pipe up to the expansion vessel must not have any valves on it. Generally, it's on the return. That means that there's no two-port valves or any control valves that can shut. It needs to have an accurate pressure reading of the whole heating system without there ever being a way for it to be accidentally shut off. Flows and returns in down below, and also our link pipe up to our expansion vessel. And now we've just got to get up here. We've got to do our cold water main in. So we've got our cold coming across here and down and in. Then we've got our balanced cold out, which is going to pop out up here and kind of hug that other cold main, so it's nice and neat. And then we've got our hot that's going to come around here, probably down the back of these two pipes and into the hot outlet just down there. So we'll just do that very quickly right now. And I don't know why I spoke Scottish. It's just my favorite accent to do. I'll try and do Geordie. I'm like, why are you, man? I kind of do it. Right, anyway, let's move on. Now, what I always do, Brasso, okay? Just buy some, Mr. Apprentice, pop it in your bag, and believe me, Brasso is the way to get noticed by your customers, by your boss. In 1911, every time they put brass in a ship, it was kept polished and clean. See your airing cupboard as your little bit of shit. Just don't do a Titanic on it, all right? We all know what happens there.
Oh, I'll never let go, Jack.
The thing is, right, about pipework, you can get your pipework in, you can solder it in and everything. You can do whatever you want to get it straight. Sometimes pipes just have a little bit of a fight with you. This here, if we look, it's just nicking out the back there. So I'm gonna give that a little bit of a push in. But before I do that, I am gonna wang some Brasso on here. Let's see, it starts to shine up and come out. So now, look, we get down here. Now I'm just gonna carry on and get this beast piped up. Right then guys, so there you go, all done. As you can see, it's looking absolutely brilliant. I've just pressure tested it as well, and you know what? We've got no leaks. And we've probably got getting on for about 200, 250 joints there. Even the best of us get a little weep sometimes. So it's nice, you know, it's Friday afternoon, and I've filled that lot up and we haven't got a leak as well, so I'm really, really pleased. Remember that you have to have a G3 certificate. You need to be a competent person to be able to work on unvented cylinders. This video is not there to show you how to install one of them. It's just giving you an idea about Range's system of a pre-plumb beast, which I absolutely love, but also how to lay out your pipework, make it look nice, and also give you an idea of the principle of unvented hot water cylinders. A couple of things you need to think about, especially with these ones here being pre-plumbed, check the joints because they've been in transit and sometimes they can work loose, and also make sure you check the immersions, okay? They always come with a little special spanner, or these ones do, the Tribunes do, so make sure you use that little special spanner just to give those immersions a little nip up before you fill up. I've just got to say, I'm so impressed with this cylinder. It's made this this job so much more easier. It's so neat. The pre-plumbed aspect of it, having the pipes just go down like that, just makes things so much easier for us to do. I'm absolutely chuffed with it and it looks absolutely great. So guys, before we finish, let's have a quick look at the installation itself and I'll tell you where all the pipes go. So first things first, we've got our flow from our boiler in here. These two pipes are the flow and return to the radiators upstairs. In a minute, I'm gonna be putting on the Magna Clean on this return pipe here. And then if we look down, we've got our underfloor heating manifold. This is all from Buteline. And then we've got our pipes here. So look, let's have a quick look at what we've got here. The pipe nearest us is our common return back. Picks up the cold return back here, pops up here, picks up the return from our radiators and then goes back across up to the boiler. So the next pipe there closest is the flow going into the actual hot water side of the underfloor heating. And then the pipe right at the back is our flow pipe for our radiators upstairs. So there you go guys, all done, beautiful tank sat there now. Basically I've just got to put a Magna Clean on the return, but I've already pressurised to air and I'm happy everything's okay. And I've already got the hot water on and the cold on as well. Please do subscribe to our videos, I hope you've enjoyed it guys. Follow us on Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and just have the fun of plumbing in your veins. See you soon guys, hold Zach.